Welcome to the video news of the week. Colebrook residents gathered at the Colebrook Academy and Elementary School Gymnasium on Tuesday evening, March 13th, for the annual town meeting. The first presented article regarded the selection of town officers. Much attention centered around the school board positions that were up for election. The three-year position of board member Tanya Young, the three-year position of board member Deborah Green, who opted not to run for re-election, and the two-year position held by Brian Griffin, who had been selected to fill out the remainder of board member Joey Sweat's term after his resignation this past year.
The school board for the two-year term, David Brooks, 267, Brian Griffin, 151. For the school board for the three-year term, Julie Bruno, 276, Kylie Manning, 241, Tanya Young, 146, Michelle Strasburger, 104.
All three of the newly elected board members had made a unified effort for the positions in a visible campaign around town, stemming primarily from opposition to the controversial school expansion proposal that dominated last week's annual school board meeting. All but one of the presented articles were approved during the town meeting, including a $3.2 million budget for general government and $267,500 for capital reserve funds. The only article that was turned down had been submitted by petition and would have asked the town to record and live stream all meetings. Town manager Tim Stevens gave a presentation to those in attendance about the upcoming total solar eclipse, which is expected to draw a massive number of visitors to the area. The North Country is in a prime viewing location for the upcoming eclipse, and Stevens advised on factors, risks, and proper preparations for businesses and residents.
Landowners, if you are a landowner, if your land has borders, Route 26 or Route 3, you might want to consider putting a couple, or any other of the main roads, you might want to consider putting up some stakes with some tape on it. People coming up here could be coming from a long distance away, don't know what mud season is in the North Country. They see a field and think it would be a good place to pull in to watch the eclipse from, and it might be June till they can get out of there.
At the start of the meeting, Colebrook resident Brad Sheltry was recognized as the town's Citizen of the Year. A presentation was given by Wayne Frizzell, who spoke of the many merits of Brad's work throughout his lifetime in the town he was born and raised in.
If you look up the words hardworking, committed, dedicated, determined, volunteer, you will see I'm not meaning anything. While some would use their health issue to be an excuse to sit on the sideline, not our guy. If there is something that needs to be done, someone in need, he is the first in line to help. It is with great honor, respect, and pleasure that I announce on behalf of his family, friends, and community he so loves, my dear friends, Brad Sheltry, is this year's Colebrook.
Congratulations, Brad.
Thank you very much. Wow.
This week, the SAU 7 school boards announced that they have hired Dana Hilliard of Summersworth to serve as the new SAU 7 superintendent. Hilliard will replace the outgoing superintendent, Dr. Deborah Taylor, who is retiring. He has signed a three-year contract and told the Chronicle that he was excited to take on the position. Hilliard brings 23 years of service in public education, and in 2022, the Chronicle spoke with Hilliard during a campaign bid for executive council.
The great thing that under this new districting and configuration is that the story and history of the majority of District 1 is the same. It was communities that had their height during the Industrial Revolution that then were able to survive when the shoe shop industry opened up and manufacturing was still strong within New Hampshire, and then communities that had to find their way when those industries ultimately blown out and re-get back to what their roots of history were so that they could determine what that next course of path of their success was going to be. You know, we love to pride ourselves in New Hampshire on local control, but know that that barely exists. And it barely exists because local control exists at paying the bill at the local level, but not getting the support from Concord. You know, and it is imperative that we have executive councilors that will approve state contracts that help support the local cities and towns.
Hilliard begins his role as superintendent on July 1st. The Maidstone Bridge, which was renamed a few years ago to the Janice Peasley Bridge, has reopened to motor vehicles. The bridge was closed in July of last year so the Vermont Agency of Transportation could assess structural damage. Restoration work has been completed, and traffic on the bridge connecting Stratford and Maidstone, Vermont, has resumed. The city of Sherbrooke was host to the Quebec Winter Games for the first time this year. Our Canadian correspondent Corey Bellum caught some of the action during the 58th edition of the Winter Games, which featured thousands of athletes ages 12 to 17 taking part in 19 different sports, all held in venues around the city of Sherbrooke.
Canadian pianist Sarah Hagen enthralled an audience at the Great Northwood Center for the Arts in Columbia on Friday night with her program on women composers of the 19th century, titled Wonder Women. Hagen detailed the history of various women composers and performed pieces by them on one of the pianos owned by the Arts Center.
Because she was a woman. And my theory is that it's because they couldn't play what she wrote. That's my theory.
Winter's not completely over yet, with mixed rain and snowfall coming up through the weekend. Friday temps range from a high of 39 to a low of 27. Saturday briefly lightens up weather-wise, and Sunday sees the mixed snowfall return with a high of 38 and a low of 24 degrees. Thank you for watching the Video News of the Week.